Hey guys, Beastie Boy here at the Syracuse Big East Power Sports Show 2023. Stick around.
John Prusak, editor of Snowgoer Magazine, and we're going to start our next seminar. You know, the last few years, if you look on YouTube and you look up Big East Power Sports Show, you see these meetups of these YouTubers. And to old guys like me, what the hell's a YouTuber? But I have kids, and so I found out. It's a whole new way of influencing people, of getting your message out there, and also of sharing your love and passion for something. And that's what these guys do. We've got these guys, we've got some more that are going to join us here in a little bit, and we're just going to let them talk about their love of snowmobiling, how they got into it, how they and why they created YouTube channels, and then what kind of, you know, content that they're creating. So let's go left to right. So tell everybody your name on YouTube and how you got into snowmobiling.
So I am a RevRider 550. I started my YouTube channel because I used to watch moto vlogs on motorcycles, and they would ride with their helmets, their mics, and their cameras, and while they were out there, they would talk about like snow or motorcycles, what's going on in their lives, that sort of thing. So I was like, this could be something that translates really well to snowmobiles. And I looked up cameras that could have microphones, and back in 2017, I started recording myself riding, running a microphone in my helmet, which is good for snowmobile sound, and for just talking in general, describing snowmobiles, talking about gear. As far as snowmobiling goes for me, I started when I was 7 years old because our neighbor had one, and I used to watch him drive by our front window and always wanted to try it. Luckily, my dad was awesome and got us a sled, and we've just kind of grown from there. Now we ride Tug Hill, Old Forge, things like that, which are obviously big meccas of snowmobiling here in the Northeast. Being able to be in such big areas and film not only myself, but seeing so many other new sleds, so many guys trying new products, trying new gear, has been huge for the channel. And the big thing for me was being able to try things, share my genuine opinion, good or bad. I found for myself early on, like on different websites, people might buy something, tell you how great it was, then you would buy it and not like it as much. So my goal with my channel was to always try to be as genuine as possible, good, bad, or the other, describe if I like something, if I don't. And obviously being able to do the moto vlog type setup with the microphone and the helmet makes that a lot easier and hopefully more entertaining for the viewers. So yeah, that's my channel.
Not every YouTuber is a young man with his hat backwards. I think the first videos I remember seeing about the Big East Power Sports show were by Pasty Boy here. So Will, let's give you a mic and have you share your story.
So I'm Pasty Boy. I started riding sleds when I was about 12 when my dad bought my brother and I the first sled. And we had, you know, older sleds and rode them for, you know, many years, and then eventually we rolled up by our own sleds. But then as I got into my 20s and got married pretty young, got out of it for a while, and then I got back into it in 2010, and I already had a YouTube channel at that point for a couple of years, where I was really, I had a motorcycle, and I just bought a Harley too, so I had a couple motorcycles, a couple mini bikes, and started the channel out that way. But then when I got my first sled again for many years, after many years in 2010, the channel kind of took over and became about snowmobiling. And then, you know, I always loved making videos too, so I already had a video camera and just started making videos about going out and riding. Then GoPro started coming out with the cameras. I got a Hero 2 and used that for a few years. I even still had that, you know, and even when I had a modern, you know, 2016 Ski-Doo Blizzard, I'm still using the Hero 2. I noticed in the beginning of that time, upgraded a few GoPro cameras over the years, and then went HD with handheld cameras on the trail for making videos. And so we do riding, you know, point of view videos, and then stop on the trail side and chat with the guys, and it just kind of took off, and channel did pretty well to the point where it was growing and I could afford to do a little bit with that money. And so, you know, still going strong now and can't wait for the upcoming season.
Perfect. Thank you. So in not most of the YouTubers we're talking to here are very local to this immediate area, but we have one that joined us from Canada here. Tell us your story briefly.
Yeah, so I'm Jesse. I'm from Toronto, Canada. I currently live in downstate New York. I went back to school down there. I've been snowmobiling since I was probably 3. And then when I, probably around 10 to 11, I started riding a lot more. And then a buddy of mine, when I was about 5 years ago, he really wanted to start a YouTube channel. So I said I'd help him with it. And really it turned into a channel where we talk about how to install accessories on sleds, do reviews on sleds. But the biggest thing that we tried to push is getting younger generations into volunteering in snowmobiling. So like I'm 24, I snowmobile a lot, but I also give back to the snowmobile clubs and I'm a volunteer groomer operator. So one of the big missions we had with our channel was to try to get that younger generation into the sport. And we're slowly seeing that that's happening and that's great. But on top of that, really, we just love snowmobiling. And so we do videos on saddlebag rides and tours and talk about like where to stop, where to eat, where to stay. And yeah, just kind of spread the love for the sport.
Very good, thank you. And as you guys can probably tell, these two are identical twins. Very, very similar. One thing that's always fun when you have a YouTube channel is adding an entertainment value to your content. And this is a guy who adds a lot of entertainment value to his content. So share your story.
What's going on, guys? So I am Upstate Blake. You might have seen, you might have seen some of my TikTok videos, scream wheelies a lot. If you want to go lose some brain cells, go check that out. But we've been snowmobiling our whole entire life. I'm 29 years old, been doing it since I was 3 years old. Starting from a Kitty Cat, Yamaha Bravo, a couple of fan-cooled sleds, all the way, worked my way up through the Rains and Fire Cats, and kind of a cat, art of cat guy. I've always been my whole life. You might know that about me, but just an absolute passion and love for snowmobiling kind of evolved into making videos in my bedroom as a joke. And, you know, honestly, really watching these guys over the last couple of years is what got me into the YouTube game. I'm kind of new to it. It's been about a year and a half I started making videos because on one side, it's fun to be entertaining and make everybody laugh, which is what I love to do. But on the flip side, I do like being informative and like getting some good trail content and just kind of sharing my love with snowmobiling with the whoever wants to watch. That's a little bit about me.
Thank you. And you know, some of these guys have become YouTube famous. Other people had some fame beforehand, like this gentleman sitting here, started out in racing and evolved into being a, I guess, social media influencer. Share your story, Jesse.
How's everyone doing today?
Oh, that's loud.
So, yeah, as John said, I did have a career before I got into the YouTube side of thing, and I started racing. Actually, my first mechanic ever sitting in the stands right there, Ziggy, wave to everyone. So I learned a lot of my stuff from Ziggy. He was the first one that kind of stepped into my world and taught me all about the sleds and how they worked and how they functioned and what did what. So when I did retire from racing, which is a couple years ago, I guess I'm getting a little older now, I got back into the recreational side of the sport as I did, you know, when I was younger with my family. And I realized that there was a lot of misinformation out there. Guys didn't know how to do this or, you know, you get on all these forums and no one kind of had a spot to go to understand how sleds work and how the suspension works. So with me having a racing background and some background knowledge from Ziggy, it's like, okay, I'm going to start this channel. I'm going to really kind of give people a place to go so they can be like, oh, that's how I set that up, or that's what that knob does on the shocks, or that's how you do this. And I kind of started it with just that in mind, just help a couple people here and there. Really no intention of kind of getting where we are now, but it took off and, you know, we are here now. And I have an entire channel based around really the Matrix platform. But we do everything from suspension setup to performance stuff to riding videos and, you know, now hanging out with all these guys. And we do, you know, just videos behind the scenes of us hanging out. And it's opened up so many doors. But, you know, the root of my channel, which is Jesse James 52, which I didn't say in the beginning, is really just based around setting up your sled so you're happy on it. And you're not wasting those precious weekends that we now have that are few and far between. And it seems like they're getting even fewer and far between as the years go on. But you know, between that and, like Jesse said, getting involved in the community, you know, I'm good friends with the president of Turn Ridge Riders in Tuggo, New York, which is where I do most of my riding. So we go up there, give him a hand, you know, we're setting up trails, doing this, that, and the other thing. And right now it's just about hanging out at this event and meeting all you guys that do support us and hanging out with these guys that we only get to see every now and then. But that's really the background, guys.
Okay, so which one of you guys decided, was it last year or the year before, you're going to have your first meetup? Where did that concept come from?
I think that just kind of happened. Yeah, I think we all just, like, we talked, but not, it wasn't like a planned thing. It was just, we all came here and I was like, oh, wait, that's Rev Rider. Oh, wait, that's Pasty Boy. That's Jesse from Sled Addicts. And then Upstate showed up and he's new to the scene, so no one really knew who he was except for his videos. But, you know, we all got together last year, and now it seems like this is going to be our common grounds of meeting up.
So got a lot of guys like me, you know, have shot some short video of something going on and put it online. But what you guys do, you guys edit together pieces. You actually, you know, create a full piece of content. Let's start with you. You know, what have you learned over the years in not just shooting a video, but actually creating a full package?
So for me, a big thing I realized was a lot of the stuff before your day starts kind of really sets the tone for the whole day. When I first started, I would get on the sled, start the video, but kind of that camaraderie in snowmobiling that you get with your friends, your buddies, that's such a big part of it. And being able to kind of start the video there, set the tone, show the excitement, all that. I love to do that in my videos. Above and beyond that, recording your whole day, as funny as that sounds and having so much footage, if you turn that camera off and you miss something cool, maybe you fall off the sled or, you know, you hit a new top speed, whatever it is, you will regret till the end of your days that you didn't have the camera running. So as hard as it is to sort through all that footage, it always ends up creating the best video. And for me, that's what works best. So
as you've done this, you've probably learned things over the years. Is it kind of strange the first time people start recognizing you when you're out in public? Is that, you know, at one point you're a person behind a camera and now you're here? I mean, talk about that transition.
Definitely. I mean, obviously if you're in a community with snowmobilers, then I get noticed quite a bit. But it's funny when you just go to the drugstore around the corner and get noticed, you know that there's other snowmobilers out there in your neighborhood, right, that are watching the videos. It's pretty exciting and cool. And I love really meeting everybody that's watching the videos, and it's greatly appreciated for sure.
Blake, we'll go to you next. Has this created any opportunities as far as people you've met or sponsorships you get or anything? I know you're newer at this game.
I am definitely newer, but you just kind of nailed it. Absolutely. Starting off with the Big East, like, this was the place last year where we all end up meeting and, you know, developed some great friendships from that. And like Jesse and I just went out to Haydays a couple of weeks ago. As far as opportunities go, I mean, it's crazy when you look back. And I think the video started probably about a year. It's probably been about 2 years now. It started with the TikTok, which just came so naturally because I'm kind of a nut, if you couldn't tell, my leisure time. And then kind of playing off what Rev Rider said here is making the YouTube videos is, it's just a whole nother element of challenges with it. Filming all day, editing. I mean, editing is probably, what you think, the most time-consuming part of it. if you take an hour of footage, plan on 2 to 3 of editing. So, but no, this has just been the absolute biggest blessing with making videos and just making people laugh and trying to entertain people and share my love with snowmobiling. We did get a couple of sponsors from this. Right now we are with in the shirt Nielsen's, which you might have heard from the TikTok, Nielsen's. also Woody's and CNA Pro Skis. Best of the best, love the people. For me, it's kind of just as much the people as it is the product. And I'm really happy to rep them. This has just been one heck of a ride, and we're just getting started, baby.
So one of the biggest challenges that this sport is facing is ageism, really. We got a bunch of people who are in a lot of snowmobile clubs. I'd be considered a very young man. And so getting young people to not just go out riding, but to be a part of the club system is vitally important to this sport. And we have somebody who's dedicated to it. Talk about how you use your platform to boost that.
Absolutely. I think really it comes down to showing people that volunteering sure, it can be looked at as like a job and work, but it's really fun. Like, running a groomer is very fun. Helping sign trails and work with your clubs, you get that sense of accomplishment. You work with others in a team, and it's like a community. So like, the past couple years that I've been involved in the club, every year I come back and help them and promote it on YouTube and on Facebook and social media. And we're seeing that more and more youth are getting involved and realizing that without them, there's a problem, right? Because the generation that started snowmobile clubs and started these trails are a lot of them still running the clubs. So we need to get that younger generation involved, or else we won't have trails to ride on in 10, 20 years from now.
Did you ever think you would be a content provider? I mean, when you were back in your racing days or whatever, that you'd be creating content to continue relationships with sponsors and things?
Definitely not. No, I didn't really have this direction ever in mind. It kind of just really fell into my lap. I saw a little niche, and it annoys me when I see misinformation out there, and I'm always a helper. I always want to help, regardless of who you are. That's just who I am. So I was like, I'm going to start something to help people. So I never thought I did. I wish I did back in the day, though. I would have had a lot of really, really good content back in the day when I was racing. But no, it did. It now allows me to maintain that relationship with the sponsors. And I am sponsored by some of the best companies in this business. I mean, I have Bruce from Southside Sales and Service, who is, you know, beyond top notch. And he's been a very, very huge part of the success of my channel, and just the amount of knowledge that he has. And then it goes to, like Blake said, Woody's and Cine and Rock Speed and Nitro Trailers, if you can hear me. Has opened up so many doors that I never really anticipated it opening. And, you know, just like Blake said also, you know, we're just getting going. We're just getting in our stride now, and we're really going to, you know, take this to the next level and just keep growing as big as we can.
As long as we've had a couple people mention their sponsors or people who work with them, let's go around the horn. Anybody specifically you work with?
Actually, no. I just have done some collaboration videos for different items, but I'm not some, you know, person to go out and go to booth to booth and start, you know, peddling anything. But I'll do it, you know, if you want to throw some cash my way, bring it on. Either that or I'm retiring this year. Just kidding.
For me, I'm working with Curve Industries this year, Mountainside Products, and Fast Track Traction Studs. The other thing I want to add, I'm sure we can all agree, it's awesome that the industry is kind of recognizing YouTube. There was once a time, I've been doing this since 2017, where there wasn't much going on as far as working with companies. You'd reach out and it wouldn't really go anywhere. Now, they're so excited to work with you. They want to team up on content, create things together. And that gets, you know, stuff out to all of you guys, and just brings exposure for them and us, so I think that's great.
Yeah, in terms of us, so we work with a BRP dealership in Toronto that we're sponsored by, and on top of that, we also work with Ultimax Belts. Other than that, we do lots of videos on different products, and we might do like one-off deals with companies on promoting their product or reviewing it. At the end of the day, one of the biggest things for us is I'm not going to say something good about a product just because someone tells me to. So if I don't like the product, I just won't do the video. So, yeah. But we work with different people every year.
We'll go around the horn with one last question. We'll start on your side. If someone wants to do what you guys are doing, if they want to become a YouTube influencer, what's one tip you would give them to start out? It's going to get tough by the time we get to you.
I would say don't do it. No, I think the biggest tip is realizing that it's going to take a lot of time. Like, editing video takes a lot of time, as everyone in this room knows. And just like the amount of footage and the amount of sometimes aggravation, like you're on the trail and your GoPro freezes and now you're freaking out on the side of the trail trying to change a battery, trying to get it working again. And it's stuff that we go through, but we do it because we love making content. So in order to be successful at YouTube or social media, you have to love doing it. If you love doing it, then just keep pushing at it and eventually you'll get to where you want to be.
Definitely do it. For me, the reason of the content creating and things like that, it just kind of came naturally, and it's something I really loved to do early on. If you guys didn't know this, I was in a band and played guitar, so I was our video editor in the band, and that just kind of transferred, you know, to my love of snowmobiling. If I had one tip, it's, you know, life is short. Just make the videos, do the wheelies, baby, you know? I actually don't know. Any good tip? I'm trying to think. Like, what's one good thing, guys?
I can't say. I'm saying it out.
Come on. You're leaving me hanging here. No. Just people. The one thing that I've noticed with social media is the attention span is kind of getting reduced lately. So the number one tip is to create engaging content, whether that be, you know, interactive stuff with your fan base. If you got a dream, just run with it. I mean, these platforms now are just so great. They make it really, really easy to post. You know, there's a ton of different stuff, TikTok, YouTube, Instagram, not even necessarily snowmobiling, but whatever you love to do, just put it out there.
I feel like I could talk forever about the things I think make a great YouTube channel, but I think the biggest thing, and you have it up here on the stage, is find your niche and run with it. I mean, Jesse with the clubs, all that was something I had honestly not seen on YouTube before. Blake with the humor, making content so relatable. Pasty Boy, in my opinion, is the OG. He started it all. I watched his videos before everybody. And then Jesse with all the technical stuff. I think, you know, once you find that little thing that makes you stand out, you can just run with it, expand upon it, and that'll create your channel for you. So.
All right, so as the OG, no. Basically, you got to find what you're passionate about. And honestly, snowmobiling is my passion these days. I mean, I'd rather do that. I have a Harley sitting at home that I took out once this season. And it's sad, I'm sorry. But you really got to find what you're passionate about. If that's snowmobiling, find out what you're the best thing you like about it or what you're best at. Maybe that's tinkering in the garage. Maybe that's, you know, doing something on the trail, making, you know, content live, you know, out, you know, on the trail. But find something that you really love doing and go for that first. Get that down. Don't try to get too much technology. It gets really convoluted and everything. I'm running multiple cameras now, and it can really get overwhelming to the point where you have so much footage to work with that you don't have the time to get it done. And it just takes longer the more complicated you make it. So start out simple and build on your most, the best, the thing you like to do the best in that topic.
So this is pretty tough because those are all good points, but I guess the one thing that came to me in the last 5 minutes of these guys talking, so for little guys, dream big, always dream big. Dream big and chase those dreams and do not stop until you get them, because if you work hard enough, you will be able to get them. I mean, I know little old Jesse, you know, always used to think, wow, I'd love to have, you know, that company support or that one support, and I'd love to, you know, kind of be in the ins about these things. And, you know, I dream big, and now I'm one of those people that I have these awesome relationships with all these people and companies and the people inside those companies, and it's incredible. So dream big and don't quit until you get there.
A lot of people would probably think a person who's in the content business like me might not appreciate what you guys do, but as much as anything, I just love the passion you guys have for this stuff. And anybody who shares my passion for snowmobiling to me is all the way up there. So thank you guys for everything you do. Thank you all for attending. We got one more seminar coming up with Levi LaValle here at 5 o'clock. So come on back and look for these guys' channels because they have a lot of fun.
Thanks, John. Appreciate it.